Cool. All right, we are here with Modern Tinder, and we're about to talk cryptocurrency. I know, yes, we're at CoffeeFest here in Denver, but Modern Tinder is here. They're gonna tell us why they're here, what the heck they got to do with coffee, talk a little bit of Bitcoin and Ripple. So let's jump into it.
Yeah, absolutely. So thanks for agreeing to interview us, first of all. Very happy to be here. And so we install these machines out here.
Okay.
They sell Bitcoin for cash, and we do a little revenue share model, so our hosts get a cut of the transactions that go through the machine.
Okay.
And we've got them all over the place. We've got 7 locations in Colorado. We've just expanded into Texas. And
Where out in Texas?
We've got a location in Houston.
Okay. Gotta get on down to Dallas, or up to Dallas.
We're working on it.
Mess with us up there. Let us know when you get up there.
Yeah, absolutely. at this point, coffee shops are our most successful hosts by a long shot, especially if they're close to universities. So that's why we're here at CoffeeFest. We're hoping to meet some interesting people and maybe make some new host relations.
So people are buying coffee now with Bitcoin and with cryptocurrency, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Wow. Coffee shops all over the world are accepting cryptocurrency.
So no more excuses that you lost your wallet, that you don't have your debit card. Now, thanks to Modern Tinder, you guys can go to your local coffee shop in certain areas and use cryptocurrencies to purchase your favorite drink. That's great.
Explain to me. I never heard of Ripple until today. Explain to me a little bit. What's the difference between Ripple and Bitcoin?
Well, so Bitcoin is kind of the big dog in the space, but there's actually more than 2,000 other cryptocurrencies that are very similar.
Okay.
So to put it as shortly as possible, Ripple offers a lot of technical improvements over Bitcoin. It's very similar in a lot of respects, but the two major ways it differs are that it's actually managed by a central corporation. No one even knows who created Bitcoin. It's a total mystery, but Ripple's very transparent, created by a corporation. They're trying to integrate with a bunch of banks for payment processing right now, and they have a lot of technical improvements, so Ripple payments are actually a bit faster than Bitcoin, and they can handle a wider volume per second. But again, there's about 2,000 of these coins, and they're all a little different or a lot different depending on the coin.
Okay.
So if you're the sort who wants to get into it, then there's a fair amount of research in front of you.
Okay. All right, so last question. Now, if I want to buy my cup of coffee the next coffee shop I'm at with cryptocurrency, do I have to go through Modern Tinder?
Well, we'd be the fastest way to get your hands on some Bitcoin by a long shot, but you can definitely round it up other ways, anywhere from meeting someone and transacting hand-to-hand to signing up on an exchange, which usually means you wait a couple of days to a couple of weeks, depending on how slammed the exchange is. So, we're the fastest, but we're not the only game in town.
Got it. But if you want to get your hands on cryptocurrency the fastest, give a Modern Tinder.